Welcome back, adventurers. It's I, Dre. Today's episode, we talk about party makeup. Do you like the ideal party makeup of a cleric, a tank, a sneaky, and a spellcaster? Or do you like to play the odd ones that are, you know, all paladin, all cleric, all rogue, all bard? So sit tight, relax, and enjoy today's episode of Busy Addults. Let's start tonight's episode off by saying, Happy Birthday, Ray!
Woo! Happy birthday!
It's my birthday! I don't know what that was.
It's okay, you're excited. You're happy. You got that Jack cookie in you.
Oh my gosh, I did. I got Hungry Howie's. I didn't want to cook dinner, so we got Hungry Howie's for dinner. And I got the giant cookie. I already ate one slice of it. I might be able to eat one more slice before the end of the night.
I would have just eaten the whole thing.
I'm not a big sweets person. Like, I don't really like cake. Pie is okay. Like, so I got giant cookie. If I'm not going to finish it, at least my daughter will. Because she will eat the fuck out of some cookies.
She will eat the whole cookie in one sitting. She'll
eat the whole thing. She's a big sweet tooth.
Yeah. What you doing over there, Yankia?
Yankia?
Just yanking. Just yanking.
Well, now we have to, like, put a adult rating on this podcast.
I already do. I already put explicit content on every episode.
Yeah, we've been cursing. Like, have you not been here for the last 14 episodes?
I guess.
Cursing, talking about hentai, talking about other random shit. Talking about murdering people. I mean,
all those.
I guess I draw the line at cranking it.
Apparently, masturbation is just no go.
Yeah, listen, but you can watch hentai, but you can't crank to it.
I grew up in a Catholic household. That is a sin.
But hentai's okay. Watching hentai's okay.
Hey, I didn't make it.
You just can't do anything about it.
You just gotta sit there and be
where
like,
did we get?
I'm horny, but I can't do anything about it.
I'll just pray it away.
Just pray it away.
Unless, you know, you join the clergy and then you can diddle little boys.
There you go. Oh, yeah, I forgot. You were the diddler.
That was the nickname back in the day.
Why?
He was diddler.
Why?
I'm not the diddler. That is a bad thing.
Because I know that you've also been known as Dirt Bear, but where's the diddler? Where? Give me the origin story on that one.
I don't even remember. I just know it was with you guys. You guys are the only ones who call me that.
I don't remember.
I want to say it was Ken.
No, it was before that. It was before that. There was a lot of jokes involving certain things, and you just kind of went with it. I'm not gonna say the jokes.
I don't know specifically, like, this was the incident.
Neither do I. I just know that we would talk about and joke around about certain things, and then you're just like, roll with it.
Well, nobody's expecting that one, so that's why I went with that option.
I almost want to say it was your bachelor party, Monkey.
That was before that.
Was it? I thought it was.
Yeah.
We called him the diddler long before we started hanging around with Ken and all of them.
Okay. I just remember your bachelor party, somebody made the joke of, we were trying to do offensive jokes, and it was like, if her age is on the clock, she's old enough for the cock. And it's like... Yes.
That's one of them. Yep. Yep.
Old enough to pee, old enough for me.
There's the other one.
Yep.
And
that one's bad.
These are definitely all jokes.
Those were the jokes I was trying to not say, guys.
Well, we can still edit it
out. I was like, these can
maybe
be edited.
I'll just, like do a silence
just a long,
or something.
Beep. Long beep.
Okay, that's what I'll try to do.
Just like a 3-minute beep.
People are like, is there something wrong with this thing? Is my MP3 skipping?
No, there's just something wrong with these people. That's what it is.
Yeah, basically.
We all have that third shift mentality and only one of us work it.
Oh, I know. Anyway, guys. Thanks for visiting, and we're done with this episode. Bye.
We're done with actually the full podcast. We're just canceling ourselves.
Oh, God. Yeah, no, welcome to the Busy Adults Podcast. We're talking about, what was it again, guys? Party composition, our favorite parties,
yeah,
making parties. Yeah, just kind like of that. Like, you know, what we would like to see, maybe not for a campaign, but more of a like one-shot small campaign. Kind of almost like giggle parties.
Okay. Yeah.
Stuff like giggle that. Parties. You know, so, yes, your ideal party would be, you know, a tank, a spellcaster, a thief, or and a healer.
Yeah.
And maybe a support. But, you know, that doesn't always happen. And sometimes, you know, people don't want to play that. Well, the party needs this. Yeah, well, fuck you. I've played that enough times. I want to be this.
And sometimes you just want a party of five halfling divination wizards.
Oh my god, so many rerolls.
Sometimes you just want to have a party of all clerics and call yourselves Amen.
I love the idea of an oops all X. Like, oops all bards, oops all paladins.
Oh please, oops all bards, nothing happens other than they never leave the tavern they all meet in. Yep.
So if everybody's oops all rogues, is that a thieves guild?
It's a start of one, yeah.
It's definitely a start of a thieves guild, that's for sure.
Right? No, would first they would have like a stealth / perception off to see how many of them could see each other.
Or steal from each other.
Yeah.
It's some Assassin's Creed shit where they're just starting out.
God. Yeah, that basically I love it. Now we need to do it.
Just a oops all. But like it'd have to be something like oops all monks. Like something martial would be really fun.
Nothing
to
ever
all.
Gets past the first round because, you know,
there's so many
nothing
hits.
A flurry of blows.
But I think that's one of the good things about at least 5e is like there's a lot of flavors.
Yeah.
You know, just warlocks in general. Just starting with a warlock. Clearly, your hexblade warlock and then your celestial warlock. Those are two completely different classes. Like, once you look at them, they're so different.
Yeah.
Well, warlocks in general, you could have a party of, like, say, five warlocks. You have your Hexblade, you have your Celestial, you have your Pact Fiend, you have your Otherworld,
whatever,
and then you have your Fae. Well, it's Fae, Pact Fiend, and basically Cthulhu type shit.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
Yeah, and those are three just from the original. Those are just PHB warlocks. Like, now we got all these
And now you
these
add Hexblade and Celestial. Yeah. Right. So that right there is a party of five that, you know, you can work with.
Yep.
Celestials are like, oh, hey, I'm a support healer or type shit.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. What's your favorite oops all?
I think like an ideal oops all that I would love to see is either like sorcerers or I know Brett and I have talked in the years past of like an all cleric one.
Yes. Yeah.
Just be like, oh, hey, we are the invincible party. Because it's like you have two or three of them. You have two B healers, one kind of a support healer. You can have the other two either be tanky spell slingers or have a war cleric just sit there and be your tank and all that. It's just, it would be something fun.
Clerics are such an underrated class, honestly, because people are just like, oh, cleric, you're the healer. But like once you actually get to play a cleric, they are so good.
Yeah.
Yeah. I mean, that would be my class of choice, too, is an all cleric party. And I do want to play a cleric eventually, but haven't gotten to her yet.
No, mine's an all barbarian party.
Oh,
so much all smashing. Barbarian.
All
so much anger issues.
Oh, and they all get destroyed by one mind flare.
Oh, yeah.
Oh,
yeah.
Oh no.
Well,
you need to make a wisdom saving throw, and you're done.
And the whole party died.
Aww.
True. Very true. Very true.
Well, what was... Oh, okay. It's not oops all bards. It was oops all, like, half some things, and they had to find their dad that was a bard, like a half elf, like a half orc, and like
a dragonborn,
a halfling. Like all of these people find out that they're half siblings with each other, and the point of the, you know, that campaign was to find out who their bard mother or father is that, like, birthed them or something like
that. Yeah, I've seen that. That would be hilarious.
For the memes.
Oh my.
I'd love it. I'd do it.
It would be really fun for, like, a one shot to go up against your parental figure. They're not the big bad, but, like, mom's been needing this child support.
I already know it. It's Scanlan Shorthalt.
He only had one child out of wedlock that he knows about.
That he knows about.
That's the point. Rest of the party's coming, baby.
Oh, no. Poor Scanlan.
That would be hilarious for a one-shot for Critical Role to do.
Oh, yeah. I will say the one, if you really just want to fuck with your DM, like I said, halfling, divination wizards, all with the luck feat attached to it.
Oh my gosh.
I mean, they gotta survive up until a certain amount.
I know, I'm just, like, level three, they'll be alright. But I'm just saying, if you really want to fuck with your DM. Your DM makes that
choice. We all start at level five.
Well, you're gonna regret that choice.
Yep.
Shields everywhere. Magic armor or mage armor.
Yeah, it's a bad time. God, but can you imagine all of the dice rolls? Everything the DM wants to do is just no. It's not gonna happen anymore.
Well, then that's the time that the DM is like marathoning them, like kind of how I had you guys in these past couple. Obviously, it's been a while since our last session because things have happened, but
it's been a while.
It's been a marathon. You guys are going off of maybe a short rest over a course of 2 days at this point. Short rest.
The Elven Warlock.
Yeah.
Can rock a short rest all day long.
That's the tank right there right now.
But
the rest of the party needs full sleep. Well, did we get 4 hours of sleep? Yeah. Okay, cool. I'm good.
Yeah. Me.
The rest of the party's like all beaten to hell, and I'm like, I really don't want to do this, but are you fuckers really going to fight? We're going to fight. Okay, fine.
Yeah.
Let's draw them in. Okay. Are they all within fireball range? Oh, God, yes. Okay. Leave now while I'm corpses or burning your corpses to a crisp. Bull.
Shit. We told you. She's crazy.
Hey, I got Sky right. It's all good.
Yes.
I've yet to see you use that in a game.
Well, one of the last episodes of Critical Role, Laura, they were talking about one of their wizard friends who's elf. And he only needs 4 hours. Nobody in the party needs a full rest. And she just was like, wait, he only needs 4 hours? And Matt's like, yeah. And you could just see the wheels turning in her head. And someone said, third campaign, all elves. Yes.
Yeah, that Essek.
Yeah.
Hey, I'm only on episode 122. I'm like 13 behind. No spoilers.
Okay, gotcha. It was just so cool
to see those wheels turn. What if you had a party of elves? That'd be fun.
It'd be different.
Only 4 hours of sleep?
Yeah. I'd be cool with it.
And if they're all warlocks?
Well, they get everything back on a short rest, too. They don't even have to long rest.
Right. Mm-hmm.
Well, warlocks also have that feat or that evocation. I think it's in Xanathir's. Where it's like, oh, hey, you've made a thing and your patrons decided, like, you don't need to rest. You need, like, basically an hour of short rest. So, like, you need an hour or two a day of just, like, okay. And that's it. Like, that is, so, like, you can't get exhausted pretty much.
Oh, God.
That's I'm wild.
So I'm like, oh, my God, that'd be, like, oh, Elven Warlock that is, like, I just need to chill for an hour. Do I get an hour? Yep.
I'm good.
Let's do this.
Oh, no.
It's game time, motherfuckers. Like, oh, my God.
Maybe.
If your alignment is anything other than evil, I don't know what you are.
Yeah.
It's like, maybe you do need a long rest, my dude. Like, let's calm down.
You've been for, like, 20 days straight.
Even the barbarian's like, whoa, you got anger issues.
It's too much rage.
You'd have to be a dark elf to cover up all those bags you got on your eyes.
Yeah. But, explain the red eyes too.
Yeah.
Oh, yes it would.
Wow.
I have played in campaigns of like all fighters, and I will say like that is, and I've played in a couple because I've played in one where like the DM's like, okay, you guys get like an extra 3,000-4,000 gold to start off with on like level one. Ooh. And everyone's like, okay, first things first, we all need belts of healing.
Yeah.
Second of all, we all need potions. Like,
yeah.
Oh, you guys could buy like with this extra 5,000 gold, you could buy like armor and weapons and magical shit. And they're like, no, we need belts of healing and we need potions.
Yeah.
We'll do it with like starting stuff. We just like, we need to make sure we live.
God.
I mean, like, that's what would be my first thought of anything other than in a team comp where it's all one with no healing. That's the first thing you got to go for.
Right.
Are those things.
And then I've also played in campaigns where they're like, oh, you're all fighters? Yeah. It's same DM, like, okay, cool. How much gold are we getting? 10, 20, whatever you're starting. And we're like,
good luck, fuckers.
Bad life choices were made all of a sudden. Like, yeah, you fuckers, like DM's literally looking at us like, yeah, learn from the last time. Give you guys extra gold for, like, healing shit. And you're all like, hey, we can't die.
Yeah.
Fuck y'all. Like, oh, shit, we actually have to do tactics now? Uh-oh.
Yep. Now you're poor.
Maybe, Ray, we should just be the green teens and we can touch hands.
Touch hands. Oh, I miss touch hands.
Instead of lay on hands, he had the new phrase, touch hands, for the
touch hands
for that heel. Yeah. I love it.
Yeah, that's what they would refer to.
So cheesy.
The green teens, if you don't know, yeah, the NADPOD series, the green teens are pretty much Boy Scouts. And they get merit badges for doing, like, you know, Boy Scout stuff. And that's the first spell that you learn as a little paladin is lay on hands, because it's, you know, inherent to all paladins.
Yeah.
And that's what they would call, or they would use it, and would say, touch hands, because they're just a bunch of little halflings, halfling paladins and clerics. And
well, I mean, think of like all that, because you can just go touch, and it's all you need is one health point to get up.
Yeah.
And you start off with 5 per person.
Yeah.
That's a lot of healing right off the bat.
Yeah. Yep. And it was later on in the series where they did it. They did the touch hands. And he's like, well, like, you don't have to say it, but they taught us, like, to say it when you did the touch hand. When you did the touch hands. It's kind of embarrassing because, you know, I'm older now. But it was just really funny because you get to touch
hands. Yeah, it was.
Well, now I need to start yelling, let me touch you!
Yeah.
When I need to lay on hands with my paladin.
Ooh, I like it. I got him, the gropey paladin.
The gropey paladin.
You're passed out and he grabs you in inappropriate places to heal you. You are saved, my son. Why are you holding my dick?
I'm sorry, but Moroku was the first thing that came to mind for some reason. Yeah, I
mean, pretty much.
Moroku from Inuyasha fame.
Bees!
Why are you checking my oil?
I got one for y'all.
Yeah.
Ooh.
All the young adventurers have been defeated. All that is left is the old, decrepit farmer. So you have like a geriatric campaign of like
bartender
who've never been adventurers, or like they had the bare minimum, like the scholar who could never really go adventure or whatever. He knew his cantrips and maybe a couple low level one spells, and be like, "What? I'm tired. Let's do."
Then you got the farmer.
I need 10 hours of rest a day.
And you got the farmer with the 10x10 plot of land, and that's just all he's done is barely made a thing of corn.
That would be a really good, like, low magic campaign, because, I mean, if you're that old, you're only a level one, you know, old guy.
Nope, they gotta fight dragons.
You actually have? No!
He casts a level one spell.
That's too much. That's too much.
I take my next turn and I sit down prone.
Literally the SpongeBob.
Really, really hard on the ticker there.
The SpongeBob meme.
I need my short rest.
I'm sorry, I'm going to have to self-impose half movement on myself.
What? You need to put your shorts on.
Oh, yeah, because what putting on armor takes 10 minutes. You would have to at least double that.
At least.
Oh, my gosh.
Damn. The geriatric bard. I felt movement down below. I'm ready to rock. You know you farted, you asshole.
I cast dust. Or was it pass without a trace?
Oh, my God. Jeez, no. Oh, my God. Yeah, you're hooked on that fucking geriatric game now, aren't you?
It sounds fun.
God. It does. It sounds awesome. And if you guys don't know what we're talking about, it's a game called Just Die Already. Hasn't come out yet. At least during the recording, it may have come out by now. But yeah.
May 20th it's supposed to release.
Oh, okay. I'd be pretty close.
It'll be pretty close. So, yeah. It looks fucking great. Just look it up. Just look up Just Die Already by Curve Digital.
But yeah, the halfling, the small folk one would be fun.
Okay, so I have a game that I was playing before. Like, I wasn't playing with you guys. I was only playing with internet people.
Right.
And we were trying to think of, like, okay, we want to put our party together. What are you thinking? What do you guys want to play? And there was a goblin and a kobold. And I think it's Cult of Vedalken.
Yep.
That's the other race. I believe that Vedalken race, it starts out like as a smaller folk, but after like level X or whatever, they grow up and they're like 6 or 7 feet tall. And I was like, well, shit, should I play like a halfling or a gnome or something? So we're all really little.
Yes.
And this Vedalken, who starts out little with us, like, will grow up and be a big tree amongst all us little bushes on the ground. It was going to be like the little feral party, because we were all just going to be like, you know, like a goblin and a kobold and just like little feral animals. It didn't work out that way. We ended up picking like different races and stuff like that, but. It was
a really effective kind of like little group would be a group of kobolds, because they've got the pack tactics ability.
Mm-hmm.
Goblins too.
Oh yeah, just that'd be.
I don't know if it's the pack tactics, but they got a lot of bonuses.
They have a lot of bonuses, but no, the kobold pack tactics. Let me look it up. I don't remember exactly what it is.
I mean that stuff. Fantastic. That pack tactics is no joke. That'll mess you up.
Yes.
Yeah, because I'm pretty sure I've used it against you guys.
Probably. I think it's
You have advantage on attack rolls against a creature if at least one of your allies is within 5 feet of the creature, and the ally is not incapacitated.
So, but at the same time, it's only going good when it's going good.
I know, but you have advantage on every single attack roll. Everybody has advantage on all attacks as long as you're surrounding the fucker. Yeah. Kobold barbarian party. Done.
Right.
Kobold monk party. I hate motorcycles, guys.
Oh, I'm sure that's going to be coming down my way.
Yep. In probably a good minute. Easy.
Well, they were going pretty fast. Maybe sooner.
There's still a stop sign they have to stop at.
Do you think someone going that fast is going to stop at a stop sign?
No, man. That's why they made ditches so your face goes in them.
I can tell you from experience, the ditches don't always matter. Sometimes you go right over.
It's better than nothing, I guess.
But yeah. Kobold, monk, party.
Oh, yeah.
All the attacks. All the advantage on all those attacks. All the time.
Sad thing is, they'd only live for 5 days.
Yeah. 7 days! That's a quick campaign.
True.
We leveled up like 5 levels in one day.
How long have you been alive?
Gonna get to
level 20. 5 days! How long do kobolds live normally? 5 days!
Let me see. Is flanking a thing in 5e, or am I just like...
Flanking is a thing, but it just gives you advantage on
this. Yeah.
Yeah.
So what's the difference between that and pack tactic? Because you have to be within 5 feet, and essentially you're flanking if you're within 5 feet. Obviously...
No, I think pack tactics... Flanking, you literally have to be across from each other. Yeah. So you have to be on one side. Pack tactics is literally you can have two people in front, and you get the flanking bonus.
Correct.
Yeah.
Is that really, like... worth it though? Like,
I mean, if you're picking a kobold, it's free. Why not?
Okay, so there is no flanking rule as a default. There are options proposed. Obviously, everything in the DM's handbook is proposed, but a couple of option rules proposed in the DM handbook regarding flanks. Okay.
Yep.
I was curious.
Just while we're on the advantage on attack rolls thing, swashbuckler rogues, as long as nobody else is around the enemy, they always have advantage on their attacks.
Well, then they can't all be swashbuckler rogues, because then that would negate
the... Exactly. I'm just saying, as a class, there you go. I think you also get sneak attack, as well.
Well, if you're pretty a rogue.
Sure. Yeah, well, swashbuckler is the rogue subclass.
Oh, okay. I see. I understand. You would get sneak attack because you would have advantage because of the swashbuckleriness.
Correct. That would be the rakish audacity.
Ooh.
So you can give yourself bonus to your initiative rolls, and you also gain an additional way to use your sneak attack. You don't need advantage on the attack roll to use your sneak attack against a creature if you are within 5 feet of it.
Interesting.
That would be fun. A little party of pirates.
Basically, but no other creatures are within 5 feet of you, and you don't have disadvantage on the attack roll. Those are the conditions to where you get sneak attack every single time.
Whoa! So you'd have to party with a whole bunch of, like, you would be the melee class, the tank that would be up front. Everybody else would have to be ranged at that point for you to make sense on your sneak attacks.
Yes and no. So I picked, when we did the tournament the one time, I did the Tabaxi rogue swashbuckler. I made that character to be an incredibly fast hit and run, pick people off character. So when there's like a group of people, I can let the group take care of them. If there's a mage in the back, I can run 120 feet straight to them and fuck them up immediately.
Those tabaxis, huh?
Yes. So that's why I made that character that way. Hey, I could just slip in, kill the one guy who's fucking us up, pick off a couple other stragglers, too, while the party's focusing on the massive group in front of them. It's kind of like a support melee.
Yeah, sounds like a...
But...
Hmm.
I dig it. That's a good idea.
Yeah.
But, I mean, what is the most... So, I guess moving on, like, the most optimized three-person parties, what, like, a cleric and a paladin and a... fighter? Fighter, maybe?
I would say a mage that we've got the spells. So, probably a wizard.
I mean, yeah, if you're wanting to do optimize, like, just for three person, you want that some type of healer, preferably a cleric.
Yeah.
Druid would work. Then you want that extra support, so, like you said, a paladin would probably help.
Yeah, because you've got the tank and the heals.
Well, why wouldn't a bard take the place of the cleric?
You could do that too.
I think everybody has to like pull double duty. Like everybody has to have two things that they can do.
Yeah.
So who would be the melee class? Like the like a it would like paladin then?
That's paladin.
I love a good barbarian.
That's true.
Yeah, barbarian would be a solid because they're just tanky with hit points and shit.
Yeah, if all you want to do, if that's the only thing that that character does, is tank and hit. Yeah, barbarian.
What's a good barbarian support? Like, is a totem barbarian a support melee?
Yeah, kind of. The totem barbarian's more like resistance to fucking everything.
Everything.
Get that bear totem. You're resistant. That bear to totem's everything. No joke.
So then that's your fucking just your damage
the tank.
Yeah, that's your tank.
Yeah. Because that's what I would run. Either that or the non-killable fucking thing. But you can get the bear totem at level 3.
Yeah. I do like that eagle totem where you can just start flying. I know. Like, oh, shit, that's scary.
I know.
Flying barbarians.
Flying resistant barbarians. Because you get, I think, 3 totems total up to level 20.
Yep.
And you can use them all at the same time. There's more. Yeah. There are more.
Well, imagine in other books, but that's the player's handbook.
Yeah.
All those scary. Well, that's scary shit right there.
What's the new one? The new...
The wild magic one? I forgot what it's called.
The rune one? The rune the rune barbarian?
There's a, or is there's that a rune knight.
Unearthed arcana one?
There is a rune fighter called the rune knight, I think. That one, it's okay. I'm not a huge fan of it. Not. It's all right.
Yeah, you know.
Yeah.
I'm sorry, I'm just trying to think of, like, what it... Because, like you said, everybody has to, like, kind of have 2 things that they do so they could fill other parts of the party. But that also comes up to the DM as well. You know, I've played with groups that aren't optimized, that they have, like, a lot of spellcasters and, like, 1 melee person. They don't have any heals or anything like that, so... I'm nice. I'll supplement. I'll give you guys a healing wand or something that will help you out like that, because it's just no fun if everybody's dying all the time, especially if it's new players.
Right. Yeah, you don't want to turn them off.
I mean, if it's new players, yeah, but if you got some veterans, it's like, you know what you're getting yourself into. So, plan around it.
If you have veterans, then they're dying to just play their GIMP characters, and they'll just do whatever until they die, because they have 10 more in the can that they're waiting to play.
Oh, you killed this character? Bam! Yeah.
Done.
Oh, you killed this character? Bam!
Yep.
Motherfucker, I don't care. I'll do this for days.
Backstories. I got all their backstories. What was
it? I know. God.
I saw one that was like, if you had a character and it died, your next character should be a slightly similar name, and you join the party, and you are your kid looking for their parental figure, and it turns out the parental figure is your previous character that died, and now the party has to figure that out and then tell you what happened.
Oh, no.
I love it.
Yeah, I love it. I was like, that is brutal. Oh,
it's hilarious. I love that. I'm going to do that now.
Yeah.
Oh, no. No, like I'm not going to let you die.
The same exact character. No difference at all in abilities, feats, or anything. Just change it. I just erase it on my sheet. Write a new name. Okay, here we go. Done.
Ron Swanson.
And Swan Ronson.
Yes. No, I want my paladin to die. I have so many characters I want to play. On the paladin.
He's not gonna die. I'm gonna buy a healing arrow and I'm gonna shoot it in his ass.
Shoot it in his ass!
Yeah, I'm gonna get a healing arrow and then when you're dying, it's like Cupid's arrow.
Oh my gosh. Rude. I want to class out like popular TV shows like Seinfeld. What are the 3, like, what is Jerry, Elaine, and George, and Kramer? Like, Friends, what is Phoebe, and Joe? Like, okay, we're gonna do that later, not right now.
Oh my god.
That sounds fun like, as fuck.
Like, Supernatural, Sam, Dean, Bobby, like, class them out. Like, what? Give me them.
I mean, wouldn't they be Bloodhunters, basically?
Maybe. I think we could be more creative with that.
You struggled with that one for a second.
I think we could be more creative with that. Like, obviously, you know, there's some kind of fighter.
You're classing them out.
I know. I want to make it creative. I don't know if that's the next podcast, but that's one of the upcoming ones because that sounds really fun. Yep.
Oh my god.
That sounds really fun.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I don't know. I think that's all we've got for now.
Yeah, honestly. So, guys, let us know what your cool parties, favorite parties, shitty parties, whatever fucking group comp you like to do. Yeah.
I mean, if it was an all-bard party, there's definitely a rave party in the future.
Oh, yeah. Yeah. They're part. You're in a band. Okay. The group is a band.
Yeah.
I mean, yeah, basically.
Yes.
Okay, now which band would be the best all bard party?
Oh, good God.
Oh,
it's too many.
Spinal Tap. It goes to 11.
Steel Panther.
Oh,
yes.
Steel Jesus. Panther is the all bard party.
They are definitely the all bard for sure.
Oh, God.
Hmm.
Yep, that's it. We're all going to be Steel Panther next time.
If you don't know what we're talking about, go to YouTube. But if you're under 18, definitely check with mommy and daddy and don't go to YouTube because. No,
if you're under 18, you shouldn't be listening to our podcast either.
Yeah, that's right.
Or you should be, but don't tell your parents.
As is the things in life.
Oh, my. Oh, yeah. She's just like, yeah, you can listen to this R-rated stuff, but don't talk about jerking it.
Which I can guarantee you the kids have figured out by now.
I feel like she's on the fence, but there's holes to go back and forth. She's like a dwarf. Just
God.
What is it, Mold Earth?
Yep.
Little moles.
It's like whack-a-mole. They're hairy. They come out of the ground. Boop.
Oh, my God.
Yeah, this was nice. Thanks a lot.
Say happy birthday to Ray when you hear this.
Oh, yeah. Ha. Thanks. Somebody will tell you what to do in the outro with all the social medias and stuff, I'm sure.
Oh, wait. We're going to talk about...
Oh, yeah, you did say that. Let's talk about that.
I did.
Okay,
guys. We have stickers. I know you can't see them, but they're fucking amazing. We're going to post them when this video goes up on our social medias. Mm-hmm. All we need you to do to get a free sticker is to take a screenshot of wherever you're subscribed to us and post it to our Twitter or Facebook page. That's it. That's all you need to do. We'll DM you if we still have stickers. We have 50 of them here. So first come, first serve.
Yeah, as long as it takes a stamp to get it to you.
Yes, then Continental United States. Continental United States. Yeah. We are not rich. We make no money doing this.
We probably lose money doing this, actually.
Oh, we will. We will totally lose money doing this. Yeah. It's money out of probably my pocket, but that's okay. These are cool stickers.
They're really fun. We'll post them on like Instagram or something.
Yeah, they're holographic. Holographic.
If I screenshot... Because I'm the only one
you
on
already
Castbox
have stickers. Following us right
now. Yeah, I already gave you stickers, bro.
But I want stickers.
You have what? How many did I give you? Two, three? Probably three. No, I gave you three.
I only have one.
All right, well, go pick up another sticker.
No, these are for the fans, not for you fuckers.
Aww.
My name's not Fucker. It's Yankia.
It is Yankia, you masturbation freaking crazy person.
Oh, gosh. So much masturbation. Thanks for listening to the podcast. Make sure to do what...
Like, subscribe, share. We're on all the podcastings, Audible, Amazon, YouTube. Like us on Facebook, Instagram, all that fun stuff.
Twitter. Tweet, motherfucker.
I don't tweet.
Twitter.
So.
I know.
Yeah.
It's okay.
I barely tweet.
Anyway. All right, bye, guys.
Deuces. Well, adventurers, that was our episode today. Thanks for tuning in. What did you like? What is your ideal party makeup? You like to make that adventure party of rogues trying to start their own thieves guild, or even a bunch of sorcerers or wizards or warlocks trying to make their own cabal, or even mageocracy. So please, go to our Facebook, our Twitter, anywhere that you listen to us. Tell us what your party is or what you would like to do. And again, see you in 2 weeks. This is Drake signing out for Busy Addults.